Okay, we have two integrals on the spot. The first one is the integral of x to the ln x power, and the second one is the integral of x to the x power. Well, unfortunately, I don't have an answer for this right here. I do have a proposal, but I need to discuss with you guys. So, in this video, please just work on this first, and then we will talk about this right here later on, alright? Use special function for that one, by the way. Okay, now, here we go. Let's take a look on how we can solve this. Well, we have x to the ln x power already. In this case, we don't like to have the base being x. We like to have base e. So let's do the following. This is the same thing. As we all know, we can write x as e to the ln x power. This is still x. However, we still have that ln x on the outside. So that's what we have. And in this case, we see that we can just multiply the powers. Therefore, we end up with the integral of e, and we have ln x times ln x, which is just ln x, and then square like that. Good. But what can we do now, though? Well, just try u sub and see what happens, right? Let u equal to ln x. And in this case, we know x is equal to e to the u. And perhaps let's just do it this way. We see that dx is equal to the derivative of this, which is e to the u du. Very nice. And of course, let's take this integral to the u world. And we see that here we have the integral of e. And this right here is the u. And we have that to the second power. And then dx is what? Just this right here, which is e to the u du for the dx. This and that are pretty good because they are both of base e. So of course, we can just add the exponents. Very nice. And this right here reminds us the imaginary error function. That would be great, because as you can see, this is almost that as soon as we complete the square. Therefore, let's look at this right here. When we have u squared plus u, and of course, let's just do the magic number. You take half of this and square that, and then subtract it after that, which will end up with u squared plus u, half of 1 is just 1 half, and then square that is 1 over 4. So you add 1 over 4, and then minus 1 over 4 after that. Then the good news is, this together is going to give us a perfect square, namely u plus 1 half square, and then minus 1 over 4, isn't it? Yes. So this is all good. To continue, we see that this right here will give us the integral of e, and let's look at this part, which is u plus 1 half. Of course, I did in blue. I should keep in blue. And then we have the du. Well, this is the function part. When we have e to the negative 1 over 4, that's just a constant multiple. So remember, we can break this apart, right? So we can take that to the front. So when we do this times that, when we do this to that power, we will just have e to the negative 1 over 4 power all the way in the front. It's just a constant. And then the integral of this, which is e to the u plus 1 half power, and then square that, du. And you can guess it. Of course, in this case, we let t equal to u plus 1 over 2. So here, let me just say t is equal to u plus 1 over 2. dt is the same as du, so it's very nice. There's nothing crazy we have to do. So this is just t squared right here, and of course, we can just use that. Finally, we see we still have this constant multiple. Let's put that down, which is e to the negative 1 over 4th power. And then we have this part being this, which is the square root of pi over 4, er f I, and the input is t, which is just that. So let's put that down. We have the u plus 1 over 2. But of course, we have to go back to the x world. X is, well, u is ln of x. So right there, for the u, and then we have the plus 1 over 2. And then over, perhaps let's put the 2 and that together on the denominator on the bottom. So 2, and then this goes down the denominator. It becomes the fourth root of e. Very good. Don't forget the plus e, of course. Whew. Very fun. Now, I know this is the integral that a lot of you guys have been waiting for. You guys have been asking me for this, but if you check Wolfram Alpha, there's no answer for it, not even with elementary function. So in that case, what can we do? Well, I've been thinking, why don't we start one ourselves, and then maybe we'll be able to come with some graphs or some derivative, etc. on our own, right? So here is my proposal. Let me just write down. This is just my proposal. I am not sure if this has been done or not, but again, it's just my proposal, right? I'm going to define, you see, this is x to the x power. There's a notation for that. It's a 2 with a little x like this, well, little 2 and an x like that. But let me just define the following, okay? My proposal is that let's call x. I don't know a better name. If you guys would like to have a better name, just let me know, right? Use a capital X and then the little 2, meaning that we have 2 of these little x then with all the powers. And the input is x. Let's define this, right? Let's define this to be the integral going from 0 to x, this and that being the same. But in that case, the inside will be t to the t's power dt. That's kind of like how we come up with the special functions, because if you have a really cool integral, for example, this one, you can just use the error function, and the error function is defined in terms of an integral, right? So why don't we call this integral to be some other functions? And this is just between you and I, okay? It's just between you and I. And from here, you see, I put a little 2 because we can do more. Because if you would like, we can do like this, x, and then the little 3 of x. You guessed it, yes. Integral going from 0 to x. And we do t to the t to the t dt. How crazy is that? And the idea is that if we differentiate this function, we'll just get x to the x power. If we differentiate this function, we'll get x to the x to the x power. Very good. And remember, we know how to do calculus in the sense that if we can get the derivative and then the second derivative, we can get the graphs, etc., etc. So maybe we'll do that later on. I will show you guys how to graph this function. For now, if you are okay with this, let's say the answer to this is x2. Write it down this way, x2 of x. And we are done, of course, in this case, put down plus c. And we'll all be happy. What do you guys think? Leave a comment down below. If you have a better name, leave a comment down below. If you are new, leave a comment down below. I don't know. Yeah. Okay, before we go, I want to thank BlenderWorks for sponsoring this video. This right here is a math and science website that offers a lot of interesting courses for you guys to choose from. They have over 50 interactive courses, including algebra, geometry, math contests, differential equation, and a lot more. I do want to show you guys one of their new courses, namely the Beautiful Geometry. As you will see, each page will contain a picture animation like this, and we will have to answer the question. We will have to find out the fraction of the shaded area in red. And let me tell you, I think the answer is 1/3. And let me see, it's correct. And they will have the lessons along the way after that. And the question will get harder. So they will entertain you, and you guys will be really having fun as well. And if you guys would like more, you guys can use the link blend.org/blackpenredpen, because this way you can get a 20% off discount to their annual premium subscription. That way you get the access to all of their courses. And thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys for checking out blend.org.